It's all over Facebook, Pinterest, and Instagram. Chemical-free cosmetics. But it's simply not possible for something to be free of chemicals. If you choose to rinse your hair with vinegar, that's acetic acid. Brush your teeth with baking soda, it's sodium hydrogen carbonate. Or let's say you dye your hair with henna. That's 2-hydroxy-1,4-naphthoquinone. Guess what? You're still using chemicals. For me, the issue with chemical-free is that it's a word that's misleading. It's made up by marketing departments to scare you. Can some chemicals hurt you? Yes, of course. But they can also preserve foods, treat diseases, and do a lot of other things that can help us live better lives. In my opinion, the best way to really know if something is going to harm you is to understand the science behind it. So let's talk about it. What is a chemical? It's composed of any number of these elements. If we take an element and divide it up into its smallest particle, you get an atom. It also happens to be the most fundamental particle in chemistry. The ancient Greeks named this particle atomos, which means indivisible. And although we've since learned that atoms can be subdivided, once an atom is split, we can no longer identify the element from which it came. So an element of gold divided is no longer yellow, malleable, or even metal. So atoms are really small, and most of us don't have the tools to see them. So it can be really hard to understand their size. To get a sense of scale, a single human hair is about as thick as 500,000 carbon atoms stacked on top of each other. If one atom was the size of a marble, your fist would be about the size of the Earth. As small as atoms are, they're made of subatomic particles, which are even smaller. Structurally, all atoms consist of a nucleus, a core which holds positively charged protons and neutrally charged neutrons. About 99.5% of the entire mass of an atom lies here. Around this core are electrons, which are smaller still. They're so small that their contribution to the mass of an atom is considered insignificant. Electrons may be pretty insignificant in mass, but they're pretty important when it comes to atoms sticking together to form molecules. They bond by either donating or sharing electrons, and as a result, they form molecules we might recognize, like salt or water. This is how elements of hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, carbon, and sulfur assemble slightly larger molecules like amino acids that eventually form a string of proteins like keratin, which are a major component of hair. Yes, keratin is natural, but it's also made of chemicals. Those same carbons, hydrogens, and oxygens also make up things like waxes and oils that help form some of the products that we're familiar with, like our soothing beeswax lip balm. Here are some of the more common elements you'll see in molecules that make up our cosmetics. In future episodes, we're going to take a look at how these elements form cosmetic ingredients like silicones, parabens, polyquats, so on and so on. In the meantime, if you see a cosmetic ingredient you don't recognize, don't panic. You can put your question here and I'll try to answer it in a future vid. I'll talk to you soon. Take care.